welcome once more as we come also into the continuity of where we stopped about the mysteries of wisdom. Remember, we have done the first part, second part, then the third part, the fourth part. So this is the fifth part, the continuity, and we have to continue until we finish it. There's no rush about this because, you know, it is obvious and obligatory that we have to get all we need to get out of this. So we're talking about, you know, wisdom in church and ministry, also wisdom in family, and the relationship, and also wisdom in establishment, that is in business. So remember, we're still talking about wisdom in ministry and church. So be able to deliberate, you know, few things, putting church and ministry together. Now I want to bring wisdom into dividing of ministry from church. That is the area we want to go, you know, into it now. So I wanted to call, you know, join and continue from this junction. So I'm going to read the Acts of Apostle chapter number 20, verse 22. That's where we're going to read from. Acts of Apostle chapter number 20, we read from verse 22. And it says, "And now behold, I go bound in the Spirit unto Jerusalem, not knowing the thing that shall befall me there, save that the Holy Ghost witnesseth in every city, saying, the bounds and afflictions abide me." Apostle Paul is speaking here. Now look at verse 24. It says, "But none of these things moved me, neither can I my life dear unto myself, so that I might finish my course with joy and the ministry which I have received of the Lord Jesus to testify the gospel of the grace of God. Remember, Apostle Paul never pastored any church. No. From the history we saw in the scriptures, he never pastored a church, but he was fully dwelling in his ministry. Before you dabble on that, we're going to read another place again. Colossians chapter number 4, verse number 17. "And say to Archippus, take heed to the ministry which thou hast received in the Lord, that thou fulfill it." You have received a ministry. The day you are called, the day you gave your life to Jesus, a ministry was given to you. It's not necessarily becoming a pastor in a church, you know. Something was given to you. A gift was given to you. That gift was the purpose of the ministry. That gift was given to you to accomplish, to fulfill your ministry. Follow carefully. Understand what we're saying. Go to 2 Timothy chapter number 4. 2 Timothy chapter number 4, verse 5 and 6. It says, "But watch thou in all things, endure affliction, do the work of an evangelist. Make full proof of thy ministry, for I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight, I have finished my course, I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but also all them also that love his appearing." Apostle Paul was laying emphasis on the ministry which he received. The ministry which he received. I said it earlier, it's not necessary to be a pastor in a local church. No. I met a man of God years back. He said while he was in a church, pastoring a church, he couldn't be fulfilled. He's not happy. And when he kept telling the general overseer or the people that was ahead of him, they couldn't understand him. And finally, he said he has no choice than to, you know, go out and start, you know, preaching as evangelist. To them, whatever he's doing must be attached to the church, must be submitted to the church. That is what they think. But that is not what he received. From what he told me, he says, "I have to do my own thing my own way. Nobody controls what I'm going to do. And I can still give my tithe or whatever, support the church or whatever I want to do. I do it on my own free will. But not the church regulating what I will do or controlling what I will do, no." And now whatever he said, he really encouraged me. Because at the time I met him many years ago, I already suffered the same thing. I pastored churches for years, you know, different churches for different times and different years, but I was not really fulfilled. I keep asking myself, what next am I going to do? People come on church on Sunday, all blessed, and they go home. But while they're going home, I'm not happy. Inside me, I'm not happy. And that means me, I don't like to visit members of the church. I don't like to call them on phone or ask them how you're doing. I don't go to, you know, how do you call it, follow up. I don't like following people up, no. I like, if I preach to you, go. I don't want to see you again. It's more about evangelistical type of a ministry that nobody can explain it to me, and I was confused. But God helping me, that when I step out of church and now establish a Bible school, the Bible school, you know, spring out and beyond human imagination, that we were able to graduate more than 1,000 students in one day. I never pastored a church up to 500 before, but I graduated students up to more than 1,000 in a day. That's what we're talking about. I don't know your own case. Maybe you have a ministry, but it's like, you don't get it, and nobody's there to encourage you. And most times, if you are effective in the local church where you are, and what you receive from the Lord is a ministry that is not church, they will cast you out, or they will see you as a rebel. No. It happened to me. I don't know, you know, your own situation or what you are passing through, where you are for now. There could be ministers in a church, but there could not be any church in a ministry. We're coming to that. So it says here, ministry is a divine assignment, a life task, purpose of existence. Ministry is a divine assignment. Assignment was given to you to carry out. Assignment was given to you to carry out. Something very peculiar. Remember, the world today, radio from people on the street, you know, going to prison to preach, people at the hospitals, you know, young people everywhere, elder people, old people. There are different, you know, sectors of people alive today, if you look around in the globe. But nevertheless, that is why God has given different ministries, so that these lives will be touched, these lives will be reached. Your message and the message of the man that trained you might not be the same. The man that trained you, the man that formed you, message might not be the same. What you receive might not be the same with where you were trained. So how are we going to blend all these things, you know, to the glory of our Lord Jesus? The Bible says, the same spirit, but diversities in operation. Operation is in diversities, but the same Lord, the same spirit. Let's see that place, 1 Corinthians chapter 12. I read from verse 4. It says, now there are diversities of gifts, but the same spirit. And there are differences of administration, but the same Lord. Different of administration, but the same Lord. And there are diversities of operation, but it is the same God which worketh all in all. He said, but the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit without. Listen, what we are seeing here, when I was pastoring a church, I was, you know, doing the best I think I can do, trying to establish the elders, the deacon, the deacons, you know, the youth leader. It wasn't working. I was struggling. It wasn't working. But when I changed the administration, and now brought pastors to myself, stopped visiting members, because I was not fulfilled, I was not happy visiting them. So I stopped visiting members and, you know, put pastors around me, and those pastors would go and visit members. So I would only talk to the pastors, and pastors would talk to them. Members started complaining that I have a voice like a lion. And I can't change it, I don't know what to do. But in the Bible school, students are happy with my voice, but in the church, they don't like my voice. So what am I going to do? So when I applied this, you know, somewhere I started working a little bit. But I was not the totality of it, you know, until, you know, I stepped out fully out of church and I started a Bible school, preaching in different churches by invitation, you know, and other things that I do, like, you know, writing books, publishing books, having messages in tapes, in DVDs, things like that, but I'll come into that fully so you understand. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 1, it says, therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as you have received mercy, and faint not. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, you have a ministry that was entrusted to you by our Lord Jesus. That ministry might not be accomplished in a church. That's what I'm trying to explain. It might run a ministry attached to a church. You can also run an independent ministry that is not attached to any church. But yet, you could have a local church that once you are less busy, you can still go there. You know, my family could just go there and worship or whatever. But you that have this ministry, I met a man of God in a aeroplane when we were traveling, you know, an aircraft, and he told me that he had been preaching for one nation to another. That is his ministry. He sees his family maybe 2 or 3 times in a year. He said, this is my ministry. Today is in Singapore. Next one is in UK. The other day is in US. The other one is in Canada. The other one is in Australia. That is his ministry. And he has every amount of fulfillment doing what he was doing. Okay. As I've said this, I want to throw, you know, more light to things I've just, you know, said so you can understand it better. You see, in the narrow sense of it and the focus of this vision, it is that special calling and gift of God in a Christian life, either he or she is a professional minister or not. He might be a professional minister, he might not be a professional minister. In Africa, today we have a businessman fellowship. They are all businessmen doing their business, and they are all born again. They came together to, you know, establish that businessman fellowship. If you're a pastor of a church, they cannot take you as a member. It's all for business people. People who are doing business in the oil sector, millionaires, billionaires. And they like helping churches, helping themselves, helping other brethren. I've been invited to preach, you know, in one of their chapters. And I see what they are doing is very marvelous. Romans chapter number 12. Let's go there. Romans chapter number 12 from verse 6. It's Romans chapter 12 from verse number 6 to verse 8. It says, having then gift different according to the grace that is given to us. That's a gift given to you according to the grace of God. It says, what a prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith. 2, or ministry. You see, now ministry is a spiritual gift given to you. Ministry is a gift. Or ministry, let us wait on our ministry. Or he that teacheth, on teaching. You could teach as your own ministry. Or he that exalted, on exaltation. He that giveth, let him do it with simplicity. So people receive giving as a gift. They like to give. I know a brother that left a church where he was before, and I asked him why. He said, when I go to other churches, if I drive on the street and see they're building a church somewhere, I'll stop by and ask who is the pastor to show me, okay, pastor, you are building a church, oh, glory be to God. I want to give you 50 bags of cement. I want to give you 1,000 blocks. I want to buy all the whole zinc. He's a very rich guy to build a church. And when he go to the church on Sunday and, oh, praise God, he shared testimony of what happened in the week, what he did. The pastor will call in his office and start getting mad. Why people are doing it outside, we need this money here at the church? The brother left the church. He said, you don't want me to fulfill my ministry. My ministry is not only the local church. I have to touch lives of people, help people outside the church. But the pastor wants him to be limited in the church, and he left the church for him. If you're a pastor, think about it and say, who is that for you? Your member that want to do something outside and you want to stop them, they will leave the church for you. And they go outside. And you're not getting, you're failing. And there's the wisdom is, you're supposed to apply. You're not applying it. Now look at it again. It says, he that giveth, let him do it with simplicity. And he that ruleth, leadership, is also a gift. Arab version call it, you know, a government. With diligence, he that showeth mercy with cheerfulness. A lot of people have a ministry and don't show him mercy. Going to hospital, asking people, how are you? Giving people only a hug, it's a minister. Handshake only, it's a minister. I know a man, he said, my ministry is just to handshake people. And so that when I handshake them, he said, oh, I feel good. What happened? You cannot explain. It's just to handshake people. I met people at the metro some time ago. They say, what we're doing here is just to give people a hug. And they have some t-shirt. Can I hug you? That's all. They hug people. After the hug, nothing more. Just to hug you. You go your way, they go your way. It's a minister. How to touch lives, how to reach lives. Very, very important. So now, we're going to, you know, go into more, you know, details to understand what I'm trying to explain. He said, 10 things to be noted about ministry. One, a ministry is a giving, is a gift and vision from God. Specialization, you have to specialize in one thing. Two, a ministry comes through body, concern, desire, and solution in an area. God will give you one particular area of what you must do to and fulfill and accomplish even in the body of Christ. A ministry must have ability to provide answers and solution in an area. So your ministry is an answer you are producing to people in one particular touch of their life. It could be in hope, it could be in faith, it could be in prosperity. Just one thing. A ministry must be properly located, for it is the key to location. So you have to really understand your ministry, what they are asked to do. There is ministry in every church, but there is no church in every ministry. Mark that place. There is, number six, it says, number five, there is ministry in every church. Church have children ministry, youth ministry, you know, church have ministries. It says, there is ministry in every church, but there is no church in every ministry. Number six, a ministry must be for the glory of God and the further growth of a church or churches. Whatever you are doing and touching lives outside church, the result also must have to be getting to the church too. Like Bornking, when he preached in a crusade and make other calls, those souls, he called pastors to come and write their name and follow them up. He had done his own. The pastor and the churches have to continue by follow up. He doesn't follow them up. After the crusade ends, you might not see their bunk again for in your lifetime. Changing life is the mark of effective ministry. So whatever thing you are doing, you call ministry, it must really affect somebody for good. Working outside a God-given ministry is being out of God's favor, blessings, promotion, peace, and the upliftment. So if you step out of that ministry and want to do what you are forced to do, you will not be fulfilled. 9. Without individual ministries, our impact in life is limited and suffering is the sure guarantee. If we must have our individual ministries, that you are sure that this is what you do that gives you joy. You see what I'm doing now? I just quit my job. But what I'm doing gives me more joy than the job we have been paid. The money is not my problem, it's not the issue. The issue is to be happy, to be fulfilled. I'm happy doing what I'm doing. And this is my ministry. 10, it's the wisdom is the principal thing in every ministry. So you have to recognize that wisdom is the principal thing in every ministry. Now I want to talk about differences between church and ministry. And that's how we're going to end it, you know, for church and ministry. The difference. There are differences. So we're going to, you know, pair them together. We'll talk about that of church and difference in the ministry. So it will be, you know, the pairing one-to-one to finish it. So number one, it says church is a public property. Church belongs to the crowd, to everybody. It says, but a ministry is a personal affair. We call it single-handed ministry. Personal affair. So proprietorship. One man is running what he's doing. And it's happening what it's doing. But church is not so. Church is for the public, for the congregation. It's like, you know, board of executive, everybody's involved. It's not like that in the ministry. Two, church is a local body of believers meeting on Sundays and weekdays for fellowship and edification. But a ministry is outreach oriented. It has no Sunday service. So if it is a ministry, pure ministry, it will not have a Sunday service. But church will have Sunday service and weekdays to meet. Three, a church collects offerings, tithes, and dues from members, but a ministry depends on sponsors, supporters, sales, and willful seed faith. Ministry does not collect, you know, like tithes, but people can sow seed, people can support, you know, sponsors could come in and sponsor them. There could be support, there could be sales, you could sell materials in the ministry. Maybe you have books, you have tapes, you have DVDs, whatever. You have e-books in the internet. These are how ministries could generate funds for the continuity. Four, the church has fellowship hall. A ministry runs from an office or a secretariat. A ministry runs from an office. It doesn't have a hall, you know, where people come, you know, they want to fellowship or things like that. I met one guy. What he does is live vigil every Friday only. Or Sunday you go to a different church, but every Friday he has a live vigil somewhere. And people are coming, people are trooping there. And people are blessed. Five, the church has a pastor, board, and members. He said the minister has executive director, mostly an evangelist, and the rest are staffs. Ministry is by the director and the staff. But the church is the pastor, the board, the committee, you know, pastors under it or whatever. It's not the same like ministry. Six, the church focuses on sinners and members, but ministry focuses on one aspect of needy people's life through publication, materials, tapes, books, training, teaching, and outreach. Ministry must not be, you know, sinners, reaching sinners and converting them. No. It might be even people who are already born again, but they need to go to Bible school. They come to our Bible school, we train them. And I encourage them to go back and, you know, be part of their church and support what their pastor is doing. But if they have their own ministry and their own calling, they should go and discuss with their pastors. If it's a man that has wisdom, the Bible says men for the people who are perfect, he will understand what this young man is saying and pray for him and release him to go and accomplish his ministry before from the church. Just like Apostle Paul. When he was telling disciples that, you know, what he is going to do, they didn't get it. They didn't understand what he was saying. Or the Holy Ghost has to intervene and says, separate Paul and Barnabas for the work which I have called them to do. They're not supposed to be in Jerusalem. It's not the ministry. There are no church. They went about from one city to another city. And when they finish for months or years, they come back to the church to come and give testimony of what happened, you know, why they were doing what they are doing. But they cannot encounter something that they call the head of it, called Peter. Peter, what do you think we're going to do? No. They take decision there. Pray. Holy Ghost leading them. One thing that is essential, that, you know, very common in a lot of churches is excessive control. Excessive control. Remember when you start a church, crowd will come. That's a message for crowd, mixed multitude. From the crowd, you change your message for your disciples. Disciples, you change your message to strong disciples. From strong disciples, you change your message because they become members. From members, you change their message when they will become ministers. When you help them to discover their individual ministries. If they have individual ministries and you can't help them to discover it, what happened? They will leave you at the church because they know you have nothing to offer again. And they go somewhere else. But you have to be wise to help people in your church to discover their ministries. Oh, pastor, I like singing. Okay. Put them to the department of choir. Pastor, I like cleaning. Okay. Sanctuary keepers. Pastor, I think I like to pray. I like to walk. Pray. Okay, go and join the prayer warriors. But when they join the prayer warriors in the church, is that all? Is that all, you know, you can offer? When it is above prayer, being a prayer warrior, what else are you going to tell them? Because that's the ministry now. Springing forth. You don't quench it. You don't stop it. You don't condemn them. You don't push them down. No. You need to encourage, you need to pray to see how you can carve it out for the person. Because you don't do it, the person cannot be fulfilled. He can't be happy. And if he's not happy, he can't stay with you. Queen of Sheba told Solomon, said, how happy are the men who stays and listen to your wisdom? If people are not happy around you, they can't listen to your wisdom. And to you, your wisdom to them is foolishness. The next point again, It says the church aimed to win sinners and incorporate, nurture, train, and prepare them for heaven. It says two basic arms of ministry are practically to reach out to people and to sensitize people towards reaching others. It is not the same. Church will win sinners, incorporate them, nurture them, and they'll be in the church. But the ministry touches lives that will touch other people. The man that touched their life might not even see them again. He continues what he's doing. Next point, the church is a humanitarian organization. A ministry can be run as a business or personal enterprise paying taxes on materials. Remember what Jesus said in the book of Luke, chapter 2, verse 45, 49. He said, I must be about my father's business. I must be about my father's business. The last but not the least, he says, the church is an offshore of ministry. And the last one, he says, not every ministry must be run from a church. Not every ministry must run from a church. No, I met one evangelist that was in the church before. When he was sure of his ministry, he told the pastor, pray for him. And he left, but the wife and the kids are still members of the church. They fellowship there. And he go preaching places. Whatever he returns, he doesn't have much to do on Sunday, he go and worship with his family there. So the last one said, church operates with joint decision. Church must have a joint decision. Everybody have to come sit down, deliberate on what to be done before it could be carried out. But it says ministry is one man affair. There's no more deliberation of ministry. So if you are a pastor in a church, listen, when I was a pastor in a church, one of the things I was encountering was, I woke up one day with something in my heart, I'm sure that the Lord wants us to do. And I come to the church and announce we're going to do this, I'm going to start on Monday. Because part of my ministry is speed. God gave me speed as a grace. So when I told him I'm going to start on Monday, I end up somebody to come and say, Pastor, that's what you say we're going to start on Monday. No, we need to sit down and talk about it again. To me, if you come and talk about it, it's like you're insulting my authority. I didn't know that I will do something contrary to church. I didn't know. But when I step out of church and enter into fullness of ministry that is not church, I understand that, you know, I was wrong, because I suppose I've deliberated. That's how church is. Deliberate, talk over it, pray over it, agree with the members. Anything you don't agree with the members, if you want to do it, they will not support you. They just want you to see how you're going to do it. So most times I overlabel going outside to go and preach. And whatever that I've been blessed with, I'll come and put it in the church. Yet it's not really producing. My family keeps suffering. And the money is not there. But I'm blessed. And I put it in the church. It's not really working. So this is what we're going to stop, you know, for concerning church and ministry. But I want to end up with this. It says, one major problem that is paramount in a lot of Christianity is that every minister wants to turn to a church. And many churches are being run as a personal ministry. That was what I did. I was running church as a personal ministry. And it was really affecting, you know, the members. It's a church and ministry must have separate registration. You don't, if you're a pastor in a church and you as a pastor, you also have a ministry, you don't register church and ministry in one name. No. Church is a different registration. Ministry is also a different registration. There must be a clear line of demarcation as to which one is church and which one is personal ministry. This you must always remember. Having stated all these points, as I've said here, now you'll be able to know the wisdom. When you apply all this, I'm telling you, the results you are getting from it, you give God the glory. And if you want, remember Pastor Bornking. Give me a shout. Write me an email, pastorbornking@yahoo.fr, and I'll get back to you. You are blessed. The next time we're going to talk about wisdom in marriage and relationship. That is in part 6 as we continue. Remember, blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.